In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you three ways to turn a color photo into a black and white masterpiece using Snapseed from Google. To get started, I'm going to launch the Tools and Filters menu by tapping on the little pencil icon down there in the bottom right-hand corner of Snapseed's home screen. Next, I'm going to launch the Tune Image toolset that I covered way back in some of my very first tutorials on this amazing mobile image editing app. As soon as the Tune Image toolset appears, I'm going to tap down here on the Adjust button to bring out our menu, then I'm going to swipe down to the Saturation control. Do you remember that saturation in this app means the strength of color? Most of the time, we use this control to punch up the vibrancy in our color images to make things more and more saturated. But if you slide your finger to the left, you can pull down the intensity of your colors. As I swipe left, the colors in this image will grow more and more pastel until finally, at negative 100, we are left with a black and white. Completely desaturating a color image is a quick and easy way to convert any color photo into a monochrome, but pulling all of the color out is not enough. Now, we need to adjust our tones. The words tones here means all the different shades of gray that we now have in this image. When I go this route, my next move is usually to swipe down to bring out the Tools menu again, and then to switch over to the Ambience control. In a color image, when you increase the ambience setting, your photo gets more saturated, and Snapseed starts to even out the contrast by adding light into the dark areas of your image while simultaneously darkening down the brighter parts. When you set a negative ambience, the opposite happens. Now that we've removed all the color, a positive ambience value will reduce the overall contrast here, which is going to help me bring out some of the detail in the shadows in this photo. A negative ambience would add contrast. I'm going to swipe over to about plus 60 to add some brightness into my shadows and to simultaneously darken down the highlights, like that window frame, a little bit. To be clear, the ambience, brightness, and contrast controls in this tool are great, and I generally use them first to set my image's overall mood. But we can get even more control over our tones when we mess with the highlights and shadows sliders. In this case, it's more details in my shadows that I really want to see in this image. So I'm going to push the shadows up to about plus 50 to bring out some of the details inside of the barn that might otherwise have been lost when they were too dark. Now, in all honesty, I often have to go back and play with each slider again and again as I work on my photos, but you get the idea. The message that I want you to learn from this example is that after you drop the saturation down to negative 100, that you then need to push and pull to play and experiment a lot to turn a monochrome into something with eye-catching tones. It's the pattern here, not the individual settings for any one control, that is important. Let me show you our before and after by tapping here, before, after. If anything, I find that the horse's ears and the look on its face are even more noticeable once the red barn color disappears. I'm happy now, so I'll tap on the check mark to commit these changes and return to the home screen. If I wasn't in such a hurry to demonstrate another method for black and white conversion, then this would be a great time to save my work. Desaturating all of the colors is just one option in here. It's a method that works well sometimes, but there are at least two other alternatives. Let me open up another image, and I'll show you a different method using the Noir filter. This time, I have a photo of this amazing ranch that I saw once, just outside of Zion National Park down in Utah. I like this photo in color, but all color photos feel modern. This one looks like it could only have been taken in the past 40 years or so, since the invention of color film, or color digital cameras, and now smartphones. One of the cool things about black and white photography is that a black and white image can have a much more historic feel. When I drop the color away this time, I want to create an image that looks old and historic. I want to create something that looks like it might have been shot 50 or even 100 years ago. So this time, I'm going to bring up the Tools and Filters menu again, and then I'm going to slide down to the Noir filter. Noir is designed to create moody, cinematic, black and white images with darkroom-inspired toning and color wash effects. When the Noir filter launches, we see a stripe across the bottom with different styles. Think of the choices in here like some of the chemical processes that the old darkroom masters used to use to add a wash of color over top of their final black and white print. I'm not going to claim to know what the letters S or C or F mean in this context. That part is a mystery to me, but what I know is that you can tap on each of these presets to get a sense of what kind of black and white plus color toning this particular formula might make. Let's try the C01 setting. That's cool. This style gives my image a cyan wash and a very high contrast black and white mood. H01 has a more neutral feel, and the darker parts of this image are getting crushed down to almost inky black. Let's try something like SO2, which gives this more of a yellow wash. Now this image has a real old yellowed historic feel, which seems like a perfect starting point for this scene. So now I can refine things even further by tapping on the adjust menu. As you can see, there are four controls in here. Hopefully, if you've been watching my videos, then you already have a pretty good idea about what the brightness control will do. The grain slider is fairly self-explanatory too. As you can see, the Noir filter is adding a simulated film grain into this image, which I think helps with that old faded mood. If you don't want any grain at all, then of course you could slide this one all the way to the left. If you wanted more, all the way to the right. The filter strength control in here is the one that adjusts the strength of the toning or the color cast that is getting painted into our image. If I drop this one all the way down to zero, then you can see what this image would look like as a straight black and white. It looks okay as a neutral black and white, but I think that the additional yellow cast helped make this feel older, and I liked it. So I'm going to slide this control back up to about plus 60. Now the last control, and probably the hardest to understand in here, is the wash slider. The wash here is actually a type of contrast adjustment. Let me set this one down to zero so you can see what I mean. As I swipe my finger to the right now, watch those dark plants in the bottom left corner. Watch the light gray sky up there in the right. As I drag this one up, the darks will get darker and the lights will get lighter. If I crank this one all the way up to plus 100, then we are left with a very stark high contrast image with almost inky black blobs in the foreground and an almost paper white, or in this case, paper yellow sky. I think that this is way too much contrast for this image, so I'm going to set this one back down almost to zero. Again, the point is not to memorize my settings. The point of this lesson is to show you what these controls do and to make you familiar with all of your options. Let me show you the before and after here real quick. I like the before photo, but it feels so modern and loud compared to the after, which has a quiet, faded elegance of a black and white plus that yellow color cast and the old school grainy film look. I'm going to commit these changes, and then I'll show you one more way to turn color into black and white. Now, for the most sophisticated method in Snapseed to make sense, I need to show you a quick demo. On the screen right now, I have my animal friends and a photographer's color wheel. In photography, we use an additive light model of color. In our color model, every color has an opposite that's 180 degrees away on the wheel. The science and the physics are not that important right now. What I want you to notice, though, is that if I completely desaturate this image, like we did in the very first example, do you see how the red cat and the blue bird become identical dark tones? Do you see how the green dog and that cyan bunny become light shades of gray? My animals are being mapped to a particular brightness value, a particular shade of gray, when we drop all the saturation away. Now, this would be fine if I wanted an image where we start out with a dark cat or a bright gray bunny. But what if I want to start with the opposite? See, the problem with desaturating is that we don't get to tell Snapseed exactly which colors it should turn into light or dark shades of gray when it takes the color away. Let me cancel out of here, and then I'll show you a different way. This time, I'm going to launch the black and white filter instead. Now, I'm going to switch from the preset styles over the really sophisticated color filter option. With things at the neutral setting, you are seeing the same image that we had just a second ago. But check this out. When I tap on the red filter, the cat becomes a very light, almost paper white shade of gray. If I tap on the green filter, then the same thing happens to the dog, and so on. So how does this help us? Well, the point is that when I pick one of these colored filters, that I'm telling Snapseed to make things with that color become light gray in the color to black and white conversion process. It might be less obvious, but I'm also telling Snapseed to map things that contain the opposite of the filter's color into much darker tones. So now, let's put this into practice with a real image. All right, so here is this old truck that I stopped to photograph one day out in a cherry orchard with my big camera. That old classic truck is the subject for me in this photo. It's the thing that caught my eye, and it's where I want your eyes to go, even if I turn this image into a black and white. So just to demo, I'm going to go into the Tools and Filters menu and into Tune Image again, like we did at the beginning. Once again, I'm going to run the saturation slider all the way to negative 100. Now blink a few times. What happened to my truck? See, this is a case where just desaturating does not help make my subject pop. Now that truck practically disappears into its surroundings. So let me cancel this experiment, and instead, I'm going to launch the black and white filter. Again, I'm going to switch over to the color filter choice in here, and now I'm going to tap my way through the various filters. If I tell Snapseed to use this blue filter, then I'm telling it to map the blue parts of my original image, which would be things like the sky, into very light tones. I'm also telling the app to make things that are the opposite of blue, think warm yellows and oranges, into very dark, almost inky black tones. And in this case, the results are awful. With the orange, or the red filter though, the opposite happens, and now that old truck really stands out. It stands out because the human eye is always attracted to the brightest, highest contrast areas in a black and white image first. To finish things off now, I can tap on the adjust button and quickly add some additional refinements. I think that I'll nudge the brightness up to about plus 15. I think I'll set the contrast to about plus 15 too. And finally, I'll add a little grain to make this feel more like an image that I shot with film. Now, we have a strong catching black and white where the truck dominates your attention. I could keep refining these settings and even add additional edits in here using other tools, but I think that you get the idea. These colored filters in the black and white tool are powerful stuff. I'll commit these changes, and once again, I should immediately save my work. Now, I know this has been a long tutorial, but as you can see, there are many ways to make a black and white into a masterpiece using Snapseed. This is an art form where one conversion method just wouldn't be enough. My advice? Try each option. Try every option. Experiment and experiment until your image really sings. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.